at all.
What do you see in that water? Well, neighbors of this Cape Coral Canal are seeing red and white after painters were caught on camera cleaning their equipment in the canal. Thanks for counting on NBC2. I'm Peter Bush. The milky plume was left behind on Northwest 35th Place, just south of Tropicana Parkway. As NBC2's Gage Golding reports, not only is this gross and illegal, it's potentially dangerous to our marine life.
John Heinbuck lives a few doors down from where the paint dump took place. I showed him these pictures.
No, that's not good. That's not good at all.
An avid boater and angler, he sees all kinds of wildlife off his dock.
There's mullet jumping, there's stingrays swimming around here today. I think that's their mating season, and jacks and all kinds of stuff.
So seeing this wasn't so comforting. The picture showing someone hosing off their equipment, leaving behind a paint plume in the canal.
Now there's a lot of wildlife in here, and it's going to have a bad impact.
He's right. It can have a bad impact. Experts I spoke with say the toxic chemicals in paint can harm wildlife and the ecosystem they rely on to live.
Director of FGCU's Coastal Watershed Institute, Dr. Darren Rumbold, says this looks like a latex paint.
Latex paint has additives that you don't want in the water. Breathing through gills, you don't want paint on your gills.
It's not just the fish, manatees, or stingrays. The paint also affecting what they rely on to survive. Organisms like aquatic plants, plankton, and clams.
They're all sensitive to toxins, so it's what you can do is kill a lot of those creatures in the area where you dump whatever it is, paint.
Both experts say this dump is localized and won't impact the entire canal. However, it can be devastating to the creatures living beneath the surface.
The city of Cape Coral says this dumping is illegal. If caught, the person could face a fine of up to $500. They could also find themselves in jail for 30 days. We're in Cape Coral this evening. Gage Golding, NBC2.